Welcome to the Texas Instruments Microcontroller Deep Dive Sessions. In this presentation, we will be covering the topic Interfacing an MSP430 Microcontroller with Industrial Sensors. This presentation will be covering three main topics. We'll be talking about the sensor market and its general block diagram, MSP430 portfolio to address this market, and we will present 3 TI designs which highlights MSP430 microcontroller usage. The applications covered are temperature transmitter for 2-wire 4 to 20 milliampere current loop systems, water meters which use LC sensors and effectively make use of our scan interface peripheral, and the IO-Link sensor transmitter. The sensor market is estimated to be $12 billion worldwide, and it continues to grow quite significantly. Let's take a look at the key drivers for this growth. The main driver within the communications segment of the market, which comprises almost 25% of this market, is driven from the mobile industry, primarily the smartphones and the tablets. In automotive as well, as we strive towards one day to having autonomous cars deployed one day out there, lot of sensors will be driving this. In medical field as well, sensors are making daily life easier, productive, and most of all, more fun and enjoyable. As technologies continue to advance in both the sensor as well as in the microcontroller area, we will just continue to see growth in this area. But a rapid growth is seen in the industrial sensors. The applications revolved around process control in industrial systems, such as feedback on task completion, information on the status of a process, inspection and measurement data, self-calibration and self-diagnosis, collect product or process data for quality monitoring. In spite of the multiple applications which I just mentioned, the biggest portion of this business is still dominated by three types of sensors, which are primarily temperature, pressure, and flow measurements. There is also a big trend towards wireless monitoring, and the market has almost doubled in the last 1 year. While it will continue to grow, it's still a small portion, around 5%, within the industrial sensors market. Now, if we go deeper in our understanding of the industrial sensor market and the microcontroller use case, ultra-low power in active mode and standby mode is still a strong differentiated feature in these applications. We will talk about this later in the presentation and how the MSP430 microcontroller is ideally suited for these applications. This slide gives you a simplistic view of a general industrial sensor block diagram. You can typically split any industrial sensor system into three blocks: the sensor element, the signal processing or conditioning block, which is typically taken care by a microcontroller, and the communication interface. As you can see, there are so many different types of sensors being currently used in the market. Typically, these sensor elements have analog or digital serial interface options for connecting to a microcontroller. Mostly, the MCU with inbuilt analog peripherals takes care of the signal conditioning element, controls the signal, and communicates it with the required serial interface. Again, there are wired or wireless interfaces, and mostly all these modes of communication used are pretty much industry standards which are well suited for the applications and help for interoperability among the players. From an MSP430 MCU perspective, there are multiple series of devices catering towards these applications, and I will be talking about a few use cases later in the slides. Now we will dig a little deeper into the ADCs for sensor interface. The MSP430 microcontrollers have integrated ADC, which are typically two types: successive approximation or SAR ADCs, which have 10 or 12 bit resolution, and 16 or 24 bit sigma delta devices. The SAR ADCs are most popularly used ones due to its simpler operation, decent accuracy, and zero cycle latency or high speed of operation. The disadvantage is typically the resolution though, which is limited to 12 bits at this point of time. On the other hand, The Sigma Delta ADCs give a good resolution of up to 24 bits and much better stability as well as noise immunity. The disadvantage is mainly the lower sampling rates, and depending on the application use case, the right device can be chosen. This slide shows the MSP430 portfolio for industrial sensor market. Especially in 2014, we have released specific parts to address this market with FRAM technology. I will be talking about these advantages of this new technology in the next few slides. Also, we have released devices with 105 degree extended temperature support, which are required for the industrial applications. Lastly, the portfolio not only addresses the analog requirements with integrated op-amps, ADCs and DACs, but also takes into account the safety requirements. Let's talk about the FRAM technology now in next couple of slides. As it mentions on the slide, FRAM brings lower power than ever before. FRAM has an inherent advantage which gives speed and flexibility of SRAM with the data retention of non-volatile flash memory. Also, it helps with ultra-low power read and write capabilities, much higher speed writing capability, almost 100 times faster, and the biggest advantage for an embedded engineer is its unique capability of configuring user-defined program and data memory. This unique capability of FRAM helps a lot of engineers solve the RAM-related issues while developing C code, and also gives a very differentiated way of looking at microcontroller memory configuration. Based on the use case, an engineer can decide to have higher data memory or RAM for his application, unlike a standard offering of 1:4 or 1:2 max typical ratio of flashes to RAM. This certainly gives unmatched flexibility to engineers. This slide summarizes FRAM benefits for application developers as well as production engineers. During manufacturing, FRAM reduces programming and test times. For field firmware updates, FRAM enables more than 1000 times faster time due to its fast writing capability, and ultimately improves reliability as well as power consumption. For data logging functionality, FRAM again gives an infinite write endurance capability, which helps customers to log data as per application requirement and not constrained by the write times of typically around 100,000 on 1 million times, which is typically specified on the eSquare prompts. Lastly, FRAM has inbuilt or inherent memory protection, which helps application level IP theft. From a safety features perspective, as you can see, MSP430 devices do offer significant features and capability across all its family of devices. Right from its F2XX devices, which were introduced almost 8 to 10 years back, the devices have been having the safety features. In fact, with the new FRAM-based devices, apart from the normal features, AES-256 in hardware is our standard offering, which is really appreciated in the industry and takes care of their upcoming needs. So, to summarize, the MSP430 microcontroller offering for the industrial sensor applications, we talked about better signal conditioning with inbuilt ADCs, FRAM technology, and the safety features. Now, let's take a look at our reference design offerings for the industrial sensor applications. The first design which we are going to discuss is the RTD temperature transmitter for 2-wire 4 to 20 milliampere current loop systems. This is a very popular application in the industrial automation market, especially for process control applications. Before we go into the reference design details, let's take a look at the sensor element. RTDs, which is meant for resistance temperature detector, offer good linearity, temperature range, long-term stability and repeatability. The RTD is the measurement device used in establishing the international temperature scales. Over the full temperature range, the RTD resistance varies in a non-linear fashion from 35 ohms to 370 ohms. RTD downsides are their cost, though in fact wire wound are much more expensive than thin film, and it does require an excitation source as well as a fine resolution. A 1 degree Celsius change in temperature correlates to a 0.385 ohm change in resistance, thus demanding accurate acquisition circuitry. Measuring resistance allows for a back calculation of the temperature. The operation is pretty simple though. Inject a current and measure the voltage. Temperature can then be calculated either directly, estimated using linear interpolations, or rounded to the closest lookup table value. Now let's take a look at the application level system requirements before showing the actual reference design what we have built and released on our website. The system must perform precise ratiometric RTD measurements with 4 to 20 milliampere current loop accuracy to meet the overall system error specification. The maximum measured error of the system must be below approximately 0.4 degrees Celsius between the complete range of minus 200 to 80-50 degrees Celsius. The low quiescent current of the system must meet system alarm requirements of less than 3.5 milliampere. It should also be a small overall form factor, low cost, and use of a low power processor capable of performing gain and offset. The system should perform calibration of the ADC, DAC, and linear interpolation using a RTD lookup table. This comprehensive design provides a complete system that measures and processes temperature signals input from 2-wire, 3-wire, and 4-wire resistance temperature detectors, or RTDs the way we call it, and outputs a 4 to 20 milliampere current loop signal corresponding to the temperature processed from the RTD inputs. The salient features of this design are input capable of multi-wire probes, 2, 3 or 4 wire, very low power consumption and a fine resolution. The interesting part about this reference design is that it's already tested for compliance with standard IEC level ESD and EFT tests. This really helps in avoiding PCB iterations on solving the critical noise problems and also time to market for the companies. This reference design is intended for process measurement applications in factory automation, field transmitters, and also can be used in building automation markets. The MSP430 device in this application performs various functions, such as recording the raw ADC code from the ADS1220 device that corresponds to the temperature reading. It then applies offset and gain calibration. It also converts the ADC code to a resistance value and performs linear interpolation to overcome the non-linearity of the RTD. It converts the given temperature from the lookup table to the DAC current. After correcting the DAC gain and offset correction, it applies that equivalent code corresponding to the loop current to the DAC device through SPI. This slide now highlights the key devices used in this reference design and the key selection criteria. The ADC requires a current excitation and buffered reference inputs for implementing a ratiometric measurement. It needs to be low power to meet the loop power requirements. It needs to have low noise, high input impedance, programmable gain amplifier. It has to be a small package to fit in the form factor of the design. Simultaneous 50 Hz and 60 Hz rejection to filter the noise from power mains. Also, it should target resolution of 10 times lower than the overall system accuracy. To meet all these requirements, the ADS1220 ADC was chosen, which has 24-bit Sigma Delta ADC, and it just fits the system requirements. Now let's take a look at the DAC requirements. The target resolution needs to be 10 times lower than the overall system accuracy which is mentioned already at 0.4 degrees Celsius. It needs to be in a small package to fit in the form factor of the design. Also, the most critical thing is to have a similar interface for MCU control as well as the ADC. The DAC16-1S997 meets all these requirements and thus chosen for this particular application. The MSP430 microcontroller chosen, which is the value line G2513, just meets the system requirements both on the control side. It does meet the ultra low power requirements. It has enough signal processing capabilities as well as an inbuilt ADC and a small form factor, which is critical for this application. The last but not the least is the power supply requirement. It needs to generate 3.3 volt nominal from a 10 to 35 volt supply. It needs to have a high PSRR, low noise to keep the power supply influence on the system accuracy low. It again needs to be a small form factor, as we have seen, which is a common requirement for this whole application. And in case of a LDO selection, it needs to ensure that the junction temperature is not exceeded in the application. To meet all these requirements, the TPS7A4901 was chosen, which meets all the requirements of the power management. The second design which we are going to talk about is a water meter which uses two or three LC sensors and using an inbuilt scan interface. Now let's take a look at the topology used in this particular application. The detailed description of the rotation detection is as follows. The rotation detection can be realized by placing an inductor of a resonant LC circuit near a rotating plate. For example, the plate on the front of a screw wheel. Half of the plate is covered with a metallic coating such as copper. The damping factor of the stimulated resonance circuitry depends on the position of the inductor relative to the metal. If the inductor is above the metallic half of the plate, the damping factor is higher than if located above the non-metallic half of the plate. By detecting the different damping factors, the rotation measurement is realized. Use of one LC circuit sensor allows measurement of rotation without detecting the direction. A second LC sensor thus makes it possible to detect the direction of the rotation. Such a system is shown in the figure 1. The inductors are placed in a 90 degrees off-axis angle above the plate and a 180 degrees metallic coating is used. This assures that the damping factor of only one sensor at a time will change when the metallic or non-metallic boundary of the plate rotates across a sensor. The MSP430 FW series of devices have a specific scan interface module that can handle the complete measurement sequence. The LC sensors, a bypass capacitor for the voltage generation, and a 32 kHz reference clock needs to be connected to the MSP430 microcontroller to establish a proper scan interface module operation. The above figure shows the schematic of an example rotation detection implementation. Two LC sensors are connected to the scan interface, and then on the LCD display, the number of rotations or calculated fluid volume flow can be shown. This slide shows the simple interface which needs to be connected to the MSP430 FW device, which has the scan interface. As you can see, the main value add of the scan interface module is that it helps a significantly low power and relatively much lesser current consumption if you compare it with an external discrete circuitry versus an integrated scan interface which is inbuilt in this device. To To further enhance the capability of the system, TI has newly released the FR6989 device, which has 128 kilobytes of FRAM memory. It enhances the scan interface module along with the A320 segment LCD driving capability. Also, the device comes with inbuilt AES256, which helps to protect IP and user data. The device also has 8 input 16 channel 12-bit ADC, which is significantly lower power and helps on active current consumption, which is a very important feature for the battery powered water meters, which claim around 20 years of lifetime. This slide gives a more detailed look at the block diagram, where you can see all the modules and the peripherals which are available on this specific device. The extended scan interface module, which is put on the MSP430 FR6989 device, enhances the overall value proposition within the water meter application. Please note that there are two AFEs in this new device and an enhanced RAM of 128 bytes, which really helps the application needs. To demonstrate the full capability, TI has multiple designs on the flow meter applications, and these are all available on our website. You can take a look at the latest offerings on this on our Smart Grid webpage and search specifically for the flow meter applications. Now let's take a look at the last design which we are presenting in this session. It's the IO-Link sensor transmitter. It basically combines the RTD temperature measurement, which we talked about in the first design, and adds the IO-Link capability for this transmitter. Before we take a look at the reference design, let's first understand what is IO-Link. IO-Link is a simple and cheap point-to-point protocol, standardized as IEC 61131-9. IO-Link reuses the cables, which is unshielded copper, and connectors from the installed base of industrial sensors and actuators. It is compatible with the current syncing IO, EN regulation 61131-2, and the prior IEC 60947-5-2. Please note, IO-Link is a trademark of the IO-Link community. This information is given for the convenience of users of this international standard and does not constitute an endorsement by IEC of the trade name holder or any of its products. Compliance to this standard does not require the use of the registered logos for IO-Link trademark. Use of the registered logos for IO-Link requires permission of the IO-Link community. This slide gives you a representation of all the industry's leaders and their products which are using IO-Link for all their factory automation products. Now let's go a bit deeper and understand IO-Link. It's also called as the USB of factory automation. The reason is that there are vast similarities between IO-Link, which is used in the industrial domain, versus USB, which is used in most of our PCs and mobile applications. As you can see, the topology is pretty similar. It supports point-to-point and a master-to-device configuration. It uses PLC as a master. As you can see, the devices are actually sensors or actuators. It's a bus-powered system with a max current of 200 mA. It runs on a 24-volt bus. From a communication perspective, its frames are initiated by the master. It can support multiple communication speed, the highest being 230.4 kbps. And please note, it doesn't support a hub configuration, unlike the USB. This slide mentions the TI's reference design of complete IO-Link sensor transmitter with 24-bit RTD front end. The solution has several benefits. It's a full turnkey IO-Link sensor evaluation system which can be used for fast prototyping for factory automation application. It has a precise sensor interface for ease of evaluation, and it supports both analog and digital inputs. The layout is optimized to meet the IC-ESD and EFT stress test. It's developed on a 6mm board width, which addresses the industry standard small form factor requirements. As you can see in the small picture on the left hand side, it's almost the same size as a 6mm pencil. It's as small as that. The last aspect from an MSP430 microcontroller perspective, it does use an FRAM device which enables easy and fast as well as a secure sensor configuration update, which is one of the biggest value add in this particular application. If you take a closer look at the application, it can really help in ensuring a fast prototype for your application. It has a push button. It has a potentiometer for emulating the RTD. It can be removed to connect any analog sensor as well. It uses an analog front end which has a 24-bit Sigma Delta ADC, which is the ADS1220, and it can be removed as well to connect any digital sensor. This application primarily has the microcontroller and the IO-Link PHY as well. Now let's take a closer look at the MSP430 microcontroller which is used in this application. It's the FR57XX range of devices which were introduced in the market almost 4 years back. It does use the FRAM technology which we discussed in detail. It does have a high performance analog which is a 200 kspx 10-bit ADC, and it does comply with the ultra low power requirements with 100 microamperes of current consumption. Thus, it's a very cost effective system implementation which helps with the inherent FRAM advantage, which is fast to program and it can give less inventory management. It's very flexible and it does support the secure memory partitioning. The IO-Link PHY used is TI's 65HVD101. We also have a device 102. These devices feature integrated IO-Link PHY for the device nodes. It's available in a small package 4x4mm and it conforms to the IO-Link communication specification. It has an adjustable driver output current limit, and on the HVD101 it does have an integrated voltage regulator as well. So in this presentation we have described the three applications, starting with the RTD temperature transmitter, a different application like a water meter which uses the LC sensors, and the last part was the IO-Link sensor transmitter. Now these three were just representing a few examples of how we use an MSP430 microcontroller in the industrial sensor application. If you take a close look at this slide is obviously pretty busy, but what it gives you is a complete overview of all the different types of sensors which are used in the industrial applications. And as you can see in the next slide, TI offers a lot of designs which really helps customers from a time to market perspective and gives you a ready reference so that you can get started with your applications. As you can see, we have been on the path of making multiple TI designs so that we can address most of the sensor transmitter market in the industry. Thanks for listening through this presentation and hope you had a good time reviewing the MSP430 microcontroller usage in the industrial sensor applications. Have a nice day. Thank you.